serpent form. Super powerful. Skills are pretty good. Might have regretted going for Find Weakness and Merchant right now. Could use End of Life, more survivability, but we could tough it out for a little bit. A couple more levels and then I'll get all the life I need. Yeah, these guys aren't really default to when you're doing the old slow regeneration game. Smallest HP pool. Just gonna wait like 10 more seconds and then should be good to get back in there. Giant zombie, badass monsters. I think they have twice the HP. stepped on a magic trap there, and it identified two items. Very dangerous. Very dangerous trap. Cast the identify spell. 118 west, 22 north. Okay, just a little bit more north. Maybe if I get out of here. expect. Chainmails do not sell for much, and they weigh like 50 pounds each, so get them away from me. Alright, now is a good time, I guess, to go ahead and... graphical bug, I think. Let's get our bugs going. Fire and dirt. Let's go. Succubus. Cursed everything in my inventory. He's basically just taking money out of my pocket, is what he just cast. That's not that nice. So slow still. Jesus Christ. Getting there. Yes. Why not? White gem with my fire shield there. Let me loot it. It's destroyed. XP. Should I go in here? Elemental Tower. I don't know. This room blows. Aerial. That's it. Just there's a bunch of earth guys, a bunch of gorilla looking things. They're supposed to be gorillas. Really easy. It's gonna be a little bit painful. Oh, blinded. The thing that's scary about those blinding traps is they're summoning traps and really what they do first. There's blinding traps that just blind you for a while, and then there's some that blind you and summon a bunch of random monsters, and those are super stressful. Especially if you're an idiot and you can't cure blindness like I can right now. Unicorn horn. Training one more lore so I could learn the spell to clear it whenever I want to. These are options. But anyways, we're back. Easy run. I did step on a mana trap. Probably let my mana regen. Again, serpent form, every naga form that you could turn into, most of them cost mana per second, or mana per 5 seconds, or 10 seconds, I'm not too sure. So it's fastest just to shift. Maybe frog form does use mana, I don't know. I'm just gonna go to my regular humanoid form and regen for a few seconds. Thank you. With all the floating eyes, I mean, it's pretty dangerous in there, but the XP is decent. It takes like four floating eyes to equal one skull's XP, so. Cat off the desk.